Good morning children, I am your Nilima ma'am and today we are going to learn about the different states of matter from lesson number 1. Now in our surroundings we see different types of objects, okay, such as the, okay, here you can see such as a table, a jar full of water and the air we breathe. So all these things are called as matter. So do all these things are of same shape or of same size? The answer is no, because all these three different things are made up of different types of matter. For example, the table is a solid state and the water which is in the jar is in liquid state and the air we breathe is in a gaseous state. So this, all these three, solid, liquid and gas, are called as the states of matter. So that is how we come to know that matter exists in three states, that is solid, liquid and gaseous state. So today we are going to learn about the properties of solid, liquid and gaseous state. Now in a solid state, the properties of solids are, first of all, that all the solid matter, they have a definite shape and they have a distinct boundary. So you can see their shape are, they have a definite shape, okay, and size, and the boundaries are also fixed over there. The volume is also fixed. And one more property of solid, the solids have fixed volume and they are less compressible. Less compressible means when you look at the microscopic level, the space between the atoms is very, very, very less. That you can see that no vacant spaces are present, no intercellular spaces are present. The atoms or the smallest particles, the, all these particles of the solid matter are very closely fixed. And because of this, when you press a solid, so with the help, suppose here it is shown. So if you try to press a solid with the help of piston or just press it, suppose this table, will it get compressed? No, it will not get compressed. Suppose this glass bottle, if you try to press it, will the glass bottle will press? No. So that means the compressibility is completely absent, okay, is very, very less. And now the last property of solid is the rigidity. What do you mean rigidity? Rigidity means to maintain their shape, okay. The solids can maintain their shape, they will not change the place unless we exert some force on it. Suppose if you try to change the shape of this table, the table will not change its shape by its own unless we try to forcefully hit it hard with the help of a hammer. So there is a chance it will break. So that is how we can say the rigidity is maintained. They maintain their shape forever unless an external force acts on it. So let us recall once again all the properties of solids. Solids have definite shape and fixed volume. Okay. So as I told you, their shapes, they have a definite shape and fixed volume. Next, the space between the particles is minimum, okay. So we are seeing that the space between the particle is minimum and the force of attraction between the particles is maximum. Because the particles are very close to each other, so there is a greater force between the particles. The particles will not move away from each other. They keep on attracting each of the particles towards them. So the force of attraction of the particles is massive because of very less intercellular spaces. And the movement of particles is also minimum. It's very less because they're compactly packed. So naturally they will not move. Okay. Suppose if you are filled, suppose the marbles you take itself. Suppose in a jar you completely fill the jar with marbles. Will the marbles move in that? No, because of very less place. And they are least, they are compressible. So I told you they have that the compression is very less. The rate of diffusion is least. Okay, the rate of diffusion is least. Means diffusion means what? Now suppose if you take two wooden blocks and just press it, will that wooden blocks diffuse into each other? No, it will not. Or suppose if you take a wooden block and a metal block and fix it, will they get fixed to each other? Or will the wood will diffuse into the metal or metal will diffuse into the wood? It will not take place. Okay, so the diffusion is the least. Solids have a tendency to maintain their shape when subject to outside force, that means rigidity. So they can maintain their shape unless any outside force is being subjected on it. Solids may break under the force, but it is difficult to change their shape, so they are rigid. So children, I hope you have understood the properties of solid. So here you can see that in the solid brick block, see the particles, how they are closely, compactly packed without an interstellar spaces. And because of this, they are not compressible, okay? And they will maintain the shape. The rigidity is more, okay? And the compressibility very less. And the diffusion rate is also very, very less. This a rubber band, can it change its shape on stretching? Is it a solid? What about sugar and salt? Kept in different jars, these take the shape of the jar. Are they solid? What about a sponge? It is a solid, yet we are able to compress it. Why? So in all these three examples, if you see, all the three matter are in the solid state. See, all the above are in solid states, the rubber band, the sugar and salt, and the sponge. A rubber band changes shape under force and regains the same. So when you're stretching the rubber band, it will just change its shape, okay? So that is how it will change the shape under force. So we are forcing and stretching it, so naturally it will change the shape. But once you leave the force, again the rubber band will come its original shape. But if excessive force is applied, then what will happen? It will break, okay? So here you can see that the solid depends on the force. So when force is applied, so it will change the shape. But again, when you leave the force, it will again come back to original place. But if more external force is been applied, so there is a chance that the rubber band might break. The shape of each individual sugar. Now, what about sugar and salt when kept in jars? Each individual particle of a sugar, okay, if you take only one single grain of sugar there and if you closely look, they have actually the fixed shape. The whole jar is not the shape of a sugar. A single particle of a sugar or a salt crystal will have a fixed shape. Okay, but when you are adding as a whole sugar or salt in a jar, it will be taking the shape of the jar here, okay? So whether we take it in a hand or put it in a plate or in a jar, each individual particle of a sugar will have a fixed shape. But the shape, when you are as a whole, when you are adding it, that is completely different. They are very, very small grains which we added here in the solid jar, okay? So when kept in different jar, these take the shape of the jar. So are they solid? Yes, of course they are solid. But individual particles, single crystal also, they have a fixed shape. Okay. Now what about sponge? See, sponge is also solid. The only thing, when you compress the sponge here, the compressibility, why it is more even, we have studied that solid doesn't have compressibility. But here in this sponge, there, if you look closely, they have minute pores in it in which the air is being trapped. So when you press the sponge, the air is expelled out. It is removed outside, and because of it, the sponge is being pressed. But once again, if you leave that force, again the air will go inside and again the sponge will regain its shape. So here the sponge is a solid state, okay? So I hope you have understood. All the three are in solid state. Only here the effect of force, okay, and each individual part of sugar and salt particle have a fixed shape, whereas in rubber band and sponge you see the action of the force here, okay? Now next is the liquid shape state. So we'll see now the properties of liquid state. So if you look at the examples of liquid states, for example, you take water. Okay, so the water is poured in three different vessels as you have seen, and that shows that they don't have any definite shape. So the common thing we have taken, that is the water. So we have poured first in a bowl, then a conical vessel and a cylinder. So in all the three we have poured what? Water. And in all the three, that shows that they don't have any definite shape. They take the shape of the container, okay? So from these three, you come to know that water takes the shape of the container. And Does it have fixed volume? Yes, they have the fixed volume. See, when a milkman comes to give the milk, what do you ask the milkman to give 1 liter or 1/2 liter or 2 liters of milk? So you are saying a definite volume there. That shows that liquid has a fixed volume, okay? Definite volume. Now coming to compressibility. Now if you closely look at microscopic level, so the water molecules, so compared to solid state, they have little intercellular spaces between them, okay? So the particles of the water are little far away from each other compared to the solid state, so they have vacant spaces, okay? Compared to solid state, the intercellular spaces between the liquid state is larger. And because of it, there is compressibility. It can be pressed. See, if you just on the surface of water, you can apply little force. As in solid, we are not able to do. But in liquids, we can little press it. It is possible to do it. Okay. Now, next is the rigidity. So, can it change the shape with respect? So, here, what is the rigidity? So, there is no rigidity. It can change the shape with respect to the container. So the shape is not maintained. So in the solids, the wooden table suppose a circular wooden table was in the shape of a circular form only. Was it changing and mixed in a triangular shape or in a rectangle shape? No. Okay. But the water, if you see, the same amount of water we can pour in a bowl, okay, and the same amount of water we can pour it in a conical vessel, same amount can also be again poured in the cylindrical vessel. So in all the three containers, when we are pouring the water, same amount of water, the water was taking the shape of that container. So that means the rigidity is not there. There is no rigidity. Okay, there is it is not maintained. Why? Because liquid change the shape with respect to the container. Okay, now the next properties, that is diffusion. Now diffusion rate is higher compared to the solid state. Okay, so here you can see if you add a color to a liquid state, so the color will get dissolved or diffuse into that water. See, in the previous video I shown you how the Dettol was diffusing in the water. Okay, and even for example, you drink the aerated drinks like Coca-Cola, Pepsi, and what is present, which gas is present in it? The carbon dioxide gas. That means the carbon dioxide is also diffused in that water. So very clearly, aquatic animals, you know, the aquatic animals live in water. And how do they get the gases? So there are dissolved gases which are present in water. That very clearly shows that diffusion rate is higher in liquid state compared to the solid state. Now once again, let us recall the properties of liquids. Okay, liquids have no definite shape but have fixed volume. Liquids take the shape of the container. Now see the second property. Liquids flow and change shape, so they are not rigid but can be called as fluids. So in a second property here, liquids are called as fluids. Fluids means which can flow. See, when you pour water on the floor, it will start slipping, it will start moving. Okay, wherever it falls, it will start flowing there. Okay, even the milk, if you pour, it will start flowing. So they have a tendency to move. Why they are flowing? Because the particles, the space between the particles is little larger, and because of it, the particles in that liquid medium can move, and because of this, they have fluidity. So that's why liquids are called as fluids. Okay, the space between the particles is intermediate. Intermediate means little larger compared to the solid particles. Now coming to the force of attraction. The force of attraction between the particles is again intermediate. Compared to the solids, liquids have less force of attraction. Again, I repeat, compared to the solids, liquids have less force of attraction. There is more force of attraction in solid. Why? Because they were very, very close. Okay, they were attached to each other. There were no intercellular spaces. But here, the intercellular spaces are little larger. And because of this, the force of attraction of the particles is less compared to solids. Okay. The movement of particles is intermediate. Again, because there are spaces present between them, the particles can move. They are less compressible. So compared to gaseous state, compared to the gaseous state, liquids are less compressible. Okay, but compared to the solid, it is compressible. Okay, because there are spaces between them. Now the last property is the rate of diffusion is more than solids. So just now I explain you that all the three states of matter, solid, liquid and gaseous state, can easily diffuse in the water. Okay, they can easily diffuse in the liquid state. So the rate of diffusion is more than the solids because the particles are having intercellular gaps, and because of it the rate of diffusion is more than the solids. So here we saw that solids and liquids can diffuse into liquids. Okay, so just now I told you that solid and liquids can diffuse into liquids, and the gases from the atmosphere diffuse and dissolve in water. Even the gases from the atmosphere can easily dissolve in the water. So these gases are especially oxygen and carbon dioxide, and are essential for the survival of aquatic animals and plants. So I told you the aquatic life which is surviving in the water, okay, so how do they get the essential gases, that is oxygen, carbon dioxide? So these are dissolved in water, that means they are diffused in the water. And how they are going inside the water? From the atmosphere. Okay, so all living creatures need to breathe for survival, and the aquatic animals can breathe underwater due to the presence of dissolved oxygen in water. Thus we may conclude that solid, liquid and gases can diffuse into liquids. So already I explained you that solid, liquid and gases can easily dissolve or diffuse in the liquids. The rate of diffusion of liquid is higher than that of solid, and this is due to the fact that in liquid state particles move freely and have greater space between each other as compared to particles in the solid state. Okay, now let us study the properties of gaseous state. Now here you can see there are three different vessels been taken, but the only difference here is the vessels are here closed. Okay, they have the closed lids, in the whereas in the solid and liquid state, see, liquid state the vessels were not closed, the surface was open. Okay, so here, but in gaseous state we have closed it with the lid. So the area which is there, the air which is inside this closed vessel, so when you observe the particles, they have very large intercellular spaces. Okay, that is what you see. Now before we come to this point, let us see the first property of the gaseous state, that gaseous have no definite shape and size. Okay, they don't have any definite shape and size. Okay, when you see here, suppose if this bowl, or if this cylindrical vessel, or if a conical vessel, if you take, the air is taking the shape of that container, so it doesn't have any definite shape. Okay, it will go on hitting the surface of that vessel. It will not constantly keep stagnant at one particular place. It keep on moving, hitting the sides of that container, so they don't have any definite shape. Okay, and it doesn't have any fixed volume. Volume of the gas will change respect to the container. So depends whatever the size of that container is. So that much amount of gases can only go inside that container. So volume is also not fixed. So they don't have a definite shape and they size, and they don't have a fixed volume. Now compressibility. The compressibility of gaseous state particles is very, very high. Okay, the compressibility of gaseous particle is very, very high. If you take the gaseous particle, because of larger intercellular spaces, if you try to press it, so you can see here a piston is taken, and when you are pressing the particles are coming closer together. They can come closer together because of larger intercellular gaps, and when they come closer, so you can see the spaces they are coming, they can be pressed. And this, because of this very property, the cooking gas which we are using in our homes, that is the LPG gas, which is called liquefied petroleum gas. Okay, what in by liquefied? That means because of this compressibility, the gases which are pressed in this gas, okay, because of this pressing, the matter has changed into liquid state, and the gas which is present in the cylinder is in the liquid state because of that compressibility. That is how it is filled in the cylinder, by decreasing the temperature and by pressing it, okay, by compressing it and by lowering the temperature, this gas is being changed to liquid gas. That's why it is called as liquefied petroleum gas. And that is how when you release the pressure, that liquid petrol is again changed into gaseous medium. Okay, so gas is compressed to liquid and stored in cooking cylinders. Okay, now rigidity. So again, same like the liquid state, they doesn't have any rigidity. So the rigidity is very, very less because they are not having any fixed shape and size and no fixed volume. So naturally the rigidity is very, very less. So gaseous particle, we cannot have it. Suppose if I move my hand just in the air like this, so you can move easily. Whether can I be able to change the shape of this air? No, is it not possible? So the rigidity, there is no rigidity. Now let us study the properties of gases. Gases have no definite shape or fixed volume. Gases occupy the whole space of the container. Okay, so in whichever container it has been filled, it will take the whole space of the, it will occupy that whole space of the container. This, now second property, the space between the particles is maximum. Maximum means they are very, very far away from each other. So you can hear, you can see how the particles are very, very far away from each other. They have a larger intercellular gaps. Okay, so that's why it is called as maximum. So because of this, because the distance between the particles are very, very far away from each other, so naturally the force of attraction between the particles is minimum or very least. Okay, very, very less, or you can say negligible. The particles are, okay, the attraction between the particles is very, very less. Now the moment of particles is a maximum. Okay, so because they are very far, they are freely to move. Okay, the movement is more, maximum. So here you can easily feel the breeze because the particles are moving, and that is how you can sense that air movement. So this is how it is possible, because the distance between the particles is the maximum. So because of it, the particles can easily move. The gaseous particle can easily move. Okay, you have seen the smoke, how it is in moving, how the vapors, when they rise from the liquid state, how it starts moving. Okay, all these are the different examples how the particles of gaseous state are moving. Now compressibility. So they are the most compressible. So I told you already that solids have a largest compressibility. They can be easily be compressed because of their larger distance between the particles. Next is the rate of diffusion is more than solids and liquids. Now even the diffusion rate is much higher than the solids and the liquid state. You study that air is a mixture of gases. Okay, so how these are, that means different types of gases are being diffused in this. Not only that, when your mother is cooking something, you can easily smell, you can get the smell of that particular dish in another room. So because that smell has been diffused, and through that air medium it has reached to your nose, and that is how you have smelled it. So that clearly indicates the rate of diffusion is more than solids and liquids. Okay children, now there is one more activity. Now see here, they have taken three syringes of 100 ml and whose nozzle is been closed. Okay, so they have a closed their nozzles by rubber cork, and we have to remove the piston from all the syringes. So the piston, you know what is a syringe. Okay, so from that we have to remove the piston and leaving one syringe untouched. So in one syringe you have to leave it empty. Okay, that means the air is filled. But the other two syringes, in the second one we have to take water, and in the third one we have to fill that syringe with the chalk pieces. Now you have to insert the piston back in all the three syringes, and before inserting, what you do is, you know, the piston has a rubber lid over here, so to that you apply Vaseline, so for the smooth movement. Okay, so insert the piston back into syringe, so you can apply some Vaseline on the piston before inserting them into the syringes for the smooth movement. And when you try to compress it, which syringe you will see the movement will be very easy. Okay, in which syringe you will see the movement will be very fast. naturally the syringe in which air is present, only air is present. Okay, the air, suppose this is the air particles, and when you are pressed, there was a movement of the piston, was very easy. In the case of water, if suppose water was taken here, the movement of piston will be little hard. Okay, little harder, compressibility. So what you are looking here is a compressibility. Okay, so if the water is taken, then the piston movement will be little harder compared to the gaseous state. In the gaseous, the air, the movement was very easily movable. Whereas in the chalk pieces, suppose if there are chalk pieces, the movement will not be so easy. We have to exert greater force in order to compress it. So from this example, we come to know that gases have more compressibility compared to liquids, and solids have the least compressibility. Okay, children. So I hope you understood or you have the conclusion here. So let us see the conclusion here. So now, basing on this activity, so there are some points given here of the conclusion. So you can just go through it. Okay, already I have explained you all these examples. So once again, you can read this. Now here you can see the liquefied petroleum gas cylinder that we get in our home for cooking, or the oxygen supplied to the hospital cylinder, is compressed gas. Okay, and even the compressed natural gas is all, which is used as fuel in vehicles, it has a very high compressibility, and they have large volume of gases, is also being compressed in a small cylinder and can be transported very easily. So all these examples are the examples of diffusion. So here these two are the examples of the compressibility of gaseous state, and here is the example of the diffusion rate of gases, which are very high in the gaseous particle. Okay, now the pressure. Okay, now you see there is a random movement of particles in all the direction, and also the walls of the container. The pressure exerted by the gas is because of this force exerted by the gas particles per unit area on the walls of the container. Okay, so let us see here some examples, then you will understand. So the effect of diffusion pressure on the states of matter. So here the example of copper sulfur and water is been given. So you can see the diffusion is less compared to the liquid state. Okay, so copper sulfur will slowly diffuse in the water. Okay, because copper is in solid state. Next example is ink in water. So the ink is also liquid state and water is also liquid state. So ink will diffuse very fast. Okay. So I have shown you Dettol was dissolving or diffusing very fast in the water. Similarly, here you can see the aquatic life using dissolved oxygen from water. So the gases are dissolved. Okay. So diffusion rate is more in the gaseous state compared to liquids and solids. So rate of diffusion solid is less compared to rate of diffusion in liquids compared to the rate of diffusion in the gaseous state. And why? Because the vacant space in the solid is very, very less negligible. Whereas in liquids, it's a little far away, and in the gases is very, very large. Now, the example of pressure now. Now here you can see in a closed vessel, the particles of air are continuously heating the walls of the container. See, when you, for example, when you take an inflated balloon and start blowing the air in that balloon there, so the balloon will get the shape here, and if you continue go on blowing the air in the balloon, what will happen at some point, if it extends the limit, what will happen? It will burst. Okay, now same way here you can see these particles of the air particles is constantly hitting this walls of the container, and because of this a pressure is created. Okay, so when constantly, see example of the pressure cooker, in your home you must have seen, when the pressure cooker gets heated up, the particles of that vapors are constantly hitting the walls of that cooker, and there is exerting a pressure, pressure is built inside. So same thing here, when these particles collide with each other and they collide with the wall of the container, pressure is being formed. So what is pressure? Pressure is exerted by the gas, and it is the force exerted by the gas particle per unit area on the wall of the container. So here gaseous particle exert more pressure. Okay, it is a force exerted by gas particles per unit area on the wall of the container. So I hope you understood the examples of diffusion and pressure and also the properties of the states of matter. So children, I hope you understood the properties of the states of the matter. Okay, so go through this video 2-3 times and you will understand the answer very well. And today you learn all the properties of the states of matter. Okay children, bye.